בעזרת השם מסייעתא דשמיא, פה, למעלה וכן. ברוך השם. אז קודם כל, שנה טובה, מה חתימה טובה. So happy to see you all again. A new year. Thank you, Jim. Oh, you see? So, welcome everyone.
Welcome
everyone. Thank you all for coming. Shana tova, gma chatima tova. School leshanim rabot. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu rewrite all of us in the book of שנה טובה, גמר חתימה טובה. ברוך השם, we had a beautiful and amazing Rosh Hashanah, and I'm sure all of you got and initiate this year with the right food, with the positive environment, Baruch Hashem. And I'm so happy that Baruch Hashem, the shiur, the class got bigger and see more people join us. And I would like, first of all, to welcome all of you and all the new attendants that came from Aventura, for other places, Baruch Hashem, for Surfside, for Bell Harbor, for all over, Baruch Hashem. And all those people who came to celebrate with us also in Rosh Hashanah. It was really, really amazing. And we now, tonight, Be'ezrat Hashem, we're going to have a special class, preparation for Yom Kippur. But we're going to talk about, tonight, about forgiveness. A little bit louder. The reason why I want to talk about forgiveness, this is one of the most important topics that we all carry with us throughout relationships, things that we're going through with other people that hurt us, steal from us, insulted us, fight with us, make us any kind of damage that we cannot forgive them, or we don't know how to forgive them. Oh, we don't know how to move on. Things that happened a year ago, things that happened a few months ago, or even 20 years ago. I spoke to people, and I know so many people that they're not talking even to their sister or one of the siblings, or even to their parents. Last week somebody told me he's not talking to his mom over 10 years. Not even Shana Tova, not even Chag Sameach, nothing. When he go to Israel to visit, he visits all his friends instead of his parents. It's unbelievable. So tonight, Be'ezrat Hashem, we're going to learn together, how can we forgive other people? How Hashem wants us to forgive? How Hashem, he brings us every year to the day of forgiveness of Yom Kippur, and Hashem said, כי ביום הזה יכפר עליכם לתאר אתכם מכל חטאותיכם לפני השם תתארו. The Torah said, Hashem is willing to forgive us for all the entire action that we have done throughout the year, whatever between us and him. בן אדם למקום, Hashem סולח. But whatever is between you and your fellow and your friends and anybody else, I'm not willing to forgive. לפני השם תתארו, whatever it's in front of me. But whatever it's in front of בן אדם לחברו, I'm not willing to forgive until you going to clear the space between you and your friend. What do you mean? But what if I cannot? Somebody steal from me thousands of dollars. Somebody
betrayed.
My partner steal my business. Oh, my ex-husband, my ex-wife, my ex-box. All the ex-people that hurt me the most and put me down and make me so much damage. I know people that they lost everything because of one person that insult them or speak Lashon Hara. Because of him, he don't have shidduch for his children. Because of him, he got divorced. How can you forgive to someone that took your kids away from you? How can you forgive to someone that don't let you to see your kids? Can we forgive? Is something that forgettable? How Hashem expect from us to forgive to other people that hurt us? What if I cannot? What if it's not deserved? These guys not deserve it, and I want to prove it. I want to prove it. What's so hard for us to forgive others, and how Hashem expected from us, especially in Yom Kippur, right? So, in order to understand that, we're going to dive in to understand what is exactly forgiveness, what is exactly selicha, what is exactly mechila, and what is kapara. Okay? And how can we dive in to understand inside of us, in our emotion, in our mind, in ourself, how can we let it go, the things that happened in the past, and the things that we're going through, or things that we want to create in the future. Okay? And I'm sure you all can relate it to it, and you all can understand. And in the end of the class, Mizrat Hashem, we're going to do kind of meditation for a couple of minutes. That close your eyes. Okay. Not now. But in the end, and then Be'ezrat Hashem, you can go dive in and think about the person that hurt you the most. All the pain, all the emotion, and everything, and you'll be able to release and let it go. Okay? So let's learn together how can we do it, Be'ezrat Hashem, and come to the Yom Kippur with an open heart. With a lovely heart, with so much love to Hashem, so much love to others, and Hashem is willing to forgive us and gives us whatever we want, Be'ezrat Hashem, in this year. Be'ezrat Hashem. So let's begin from the beginning. How Yom Kippur begin? How we got Yom Kippur in the beginning? Moshe Rabbeinu went to the heaven. Moshe Rabbeinu ala l'marom lekabel et ha-Torah b'ma'amad ar-Sinai, the sixth of Sivan. He went to the heaven for 40 days. After 40 days, he was late for a couple hours. Right? The rabbi was late. Oh, yeah, yeah. Rabbi's always late. No, he's coming in his own time. So, Moshe Rabbeinu come late, and he realized that Am Yisrael dancing around the golden calf, and they did the golden calf. They said, אלה אלוהיך ישראל אשר הוצאתו מארץ מצרים. They worship a different God. Hashem said, go, well done. I'm going to destroy these guys. He came back, he broke the tablet, שבר את הלוחות. And then Hashem said, הרף ממני ואשמידם ואעשה אותך לגוי גדול. Leave me alone. I'm going to destroy these guys. Moshe Rabbeinu went to the heaven again. He took another flight. 40 days. From the 17th of Tammuz until Rosh Chodesh Elul. 40 days and 40 nights, and Hashem said, forget about it. I'm not willing to forgive. That's it. It's too much. Moshe Rabbeinu took another flight. When? From Rosh Chodesh Elul until Yom Kippur. This is the 40 days. Yemeh Arachamim V'Aselichot. That's what we say, Selichot. That's what we ask for forgiveness. Because this is the days of mercy. From Rosh Chodesh Elul until Yom Kippur. Moshe Rabbeinu arrived in Yom Kippur only when he got the message to his phone. Vayomer Hashem, salachti kitvarecha. He saw the text message? Okay. He ready to come back. What is Vayomer Hashem, salachti kitvarecha? Rashi Tevot, whiskey. If you want someone to forgive you, give him whiskey. So, Hashem said, I'm going to forgive Am Yisrael, not just to forgive them, I'm going to release everything and start a new page. He bring back the clouds, and then we came back to do the Mishkan, And that's when we have Sukkot. And we all celebrate again like nothing happened. Okay? Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu like that. When Moshe Rabbeinu went to the heaven, he saw Hashem taking the talit. And Hashem started to pray like Shliach Tzibur. And Hashem said, Moshe, if you want to activate my midot, my mercy on Am Yisrael, to willing to forgive them, you have two options. Or to use the credit card of the fathers. You know when you use the credit card of your father all the time? Right? But sometimes it's, how much you can, Mom, I need your credit card. What? Are you 40 years old? Why are you still using my credit card? Go work. But if you cannot use your credit card, oh, my dad is like that, my dad. Zchut avot, when zchut avot, it's over. You cannot use the parents' merits. What are you supposed to do? I give you the 13 keys, 13 buttons. This is called the 13 attributes of Hashem's mercy. 13 midot shel rachamim. Shehashem amar, ya'asu lefanai kaseder hazeh, v'ani mochelem. If you go into hard time, that I'm going crazy, let's say, you want me to calm down? How you can activate my midot and make me relax and not going crazy? Say the 13 midot of rachamim. What is the 13 attribute? Who knows? Adonai, Adonai, Elachu b'chanun, Elach afayim, Elchezve emenu, Tzachesed alafim, Sa'avon b'feshal, Chata'a b'nake. 13 attributes that says basically all the midot, all the attributes of Hashem, that Hashem is not just a big, Hashem has so much mercy, and Hashem said, I am Hashem, Hashem, why two times Hashem? I am God before you sin, and I am God after you sin. I love you the same. I forgive you. Right? Rachum v'chanun, erech apayim, I have enough patience to forgive you and not to destroy you on spot. I'm not willing to punish you on spot. When you're not keeping kosher, you're supposed to get choked. No. Continue to eat. Bon appetit. Right? I'm not going to do anything. You drive or you're not keeping something and you see something that it's okay, it's up to you. What happened to the pencil? 65. 65. So Hashem said, you want to activate? Either you say it, but the Gemara didn't say to say just the words Hashem, 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 Hashem. Ya'asu lefanai kaseder hazeh. You need to act like my midot in order to activate my midot towards you. Who knows the book, Tomer Devorah? Oh, Tomer Devorah, yafeh meod. Rabbi Moshe Cordovero, one of the biggest rabbis in Tzfat, the rabbi of Arizal, the biggest Kabbalist in 500 years ago, and he wrote the book, Tomer Devorah, that says exactly how can we relate and activate and act like God and make God activate his midot upon us. So there is a special book called Tomer Devorah, really, really amazing, and I highly recommend to order it. Also in English, you have it in Amazon, Tomer Devorah, that he say basically every midah that Hashem have, let's say I give you an example, Hashem El Rachum V'Chanun, not to have just the mercy of a person that hurt you and love him like nothing happened, Rachum V'Chanun, also to give him Chanina and Erech Apayim, and even to give him, he said, Hashem is not just carry our Avonot, Hashem, let's say he give us a screwdriver. Let's say you have an employee and you ask him to do construction. לקחת מישהו לעשות שיפוצים, and he taking the screwdriver, לוקחת את המבריגה, and he making holes. And he destroying your house. What is he supposed to do? To take out the plug out, and that's it, and kick him out. Hashem, not only that he's not taking the plug out, he continued to pay for the electric bill for you. Hashem continued to give us power to continue to drive, to see, to eat, to enjoy life, even we do against him. So the Ramak said, you want Hashem to have a mercy on you? You're going through obstacles in your life? You're going through challenges? You want to see me? You want to see salvation that you never experienced before? I want you to act like me, but I cannot. How can I do it? Somebody hurt me. Somebody took my money. Somebody took my business and flipped it against me. Somebody, my wife drove me crazy. My ex-wife took my kids away from me. Or my wife hurts me or put me down. Or she lied to me. My husband lied to me. Or my husband cheated on me. My husband did something bad. Somebody insulted me. Somebody said lashon hara. How can I forgive him? All over the city, they know what I did. It's embarrassing. I can't even show my face. How can? So how can we do it? It's nice to act like Hashem, to act like it, to be like Hashem. במילים הכל יפה, אבל איך עושים את זה במציאות? How can we apply it in the reality? To be like God? I'm sorry, but I'm not God. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. And tonight we're going to learn how to do it. How can we act like God? How can we be like Him? How can we overcome our ego, our midot, to take a deep breath, to go through it, and let it go. Whatever happened, happened. So let's see, how can we do it? And release all the pain and grudge and all the anger that we have towards those people who hurts us. How can I forgive my ex-husband, my friends, my boss, my other people that hurts me the most? So Chazal said like that. We say in the tefillah in Yom Kippur, Mechila, Slicha, V'chapara. There is a three levels of forgiveness. Okay? What is the first level, slicha, when you, let's say, I give you loan, $2,000, and I ask you, you pay me in 2 weeks. Yeah, don't worry, of course I'm going to pay you, don't worry. After 2 weeks, you don't even pick up the phone. 2 months, 5 months, you get in, Ma, Terry, it's my rent, why you don't pay me, why you owe me money? You know what? I forgive you. Slicha, just forgive you. You know what? Leave me alone. Instead of wasting the time and phone call and lying, leave me alone. That's slicha. Right? Slicha is the first level that you'll be able to let it go, but you're still going on inside cooking. And you don't want to see this guy around you. Right? Mechila, the melashon, כמו mechila, mitachat la'adama, like a tunnel, Mechila is much more deeper. Not only that I forgive you, that I'll be able to forgive you like nothing happened, right? Mechila, also I don't have any emotion towards you. I'll be able to smile to you. Oh, you owe me 2,000? 5,000? 20,000? It's okay. I forgive you. Yalla kapara, inal dina. Look, I'm forgive you. מוחל לך, and I don't have any bad feeling. אין לבן אדם שום רגשות שליליות. עשית, פגעת, הרסת לי את הבית, הרסת לי את האוטו, הורדת לי את זה, בגללך הפסדתי כסף. מוחל לך. I forgive you, this is the second level, מחילה. Right? You don't give me back my money, I מוחל לך, יאללה, move on. And it's okay, you can still be here, I can see him, nothing happened. What is kapara? Kapara, when he asks you, can you give me another 2,000? What? Now I want to see. Maza, rega amati chasem. Now I want to see. Kapara is like nothing happened for real. Not just you don't have any bad feeling. Mamash, I trust you again. You have a fight with your wife. You have arguments. She call you names. or she didn't respect, she disrespect you in front of family, friends, or whatever happened, or your husband put you down and hurt you and do something for you, not only that, I forgive you. Yeah, let's go for a day. Let's go for a vacation. Let's, excuse me, forgive you, but give me my space. I'm not going to be like years before. It's over. It's over. It's over. I thought you forgive me. I forgive you, but I still make a space. Right? Kapara, Ken, why kapara? Right? So this is the third level, kapara. I'd be able to help him or to give him or to treat him like nothing happened. That's what Hashem does. Listen, Hashem not only forgives us, Hashem not only mocheh like nothing happened, Hashem willing to give us another shefa, another panasa. We have the face to come to Hashem. Kotvenu v'sefer panasa. Excuse me? I give you panasa. You know what happened? You go to the Hard Rock? You go to all the clubs and you eat all the shrimps in the... Mom, you spend so much money for stupid things. You use the money against me. And you have the face to ask for more Shemoparnasa? Get out of here. Say thank you that you're still alive. Tagidu lebracha shlacha, eto makesh ot kesef, makesh ot chayim. Hashem, give me relations, give me my zivug. I give you zivug, you know what you did with your zivug. Walia. You know what you did, I give you everything. I give you your life, but you use it against me. I give you time, I give you health. But you try, you do whatever you want. Why should I give me a reason why to give you that? I don't know if you remember, 11 years ago, 12 years ago, before I moved to the United States, I used to live in Israel, Yeshuv, that's called Telston. And at that time, we used to live up in the hill, and it was very, very Yeridat Lula. It's not so words in English. It's a Yeridat Lula. It was, was very, and all the Kitsu, Misha and Glee Poshe. So, anyway, so one time all the buses used to go so fast, and it was very dangerous. Always everybody was concerned, like, come on, calm down. They put bumpers and bumpers. One time, my neighbor, his son, 5 year old, went to the bicycle and he crossed the street. The driver was driving so fast and he hit the guy like 100 feet forward and he killed him on the spot. Shem Shmuel. Couldn't forget.
A child.
Everybody was so much chaos that the driver was crying. He couldn't believe that he just for in a second he killed a child. The father of the family came, they took him out, the police, blah, 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 balagan, balagan, balagan. The driver came to the Shiva every day, and he was standing in the front of the house. And he was crying hysterically, and he asked, let me get inside to ask the father for forgiveness. Nobody let him in. Hundreds of people came all over to condolence the mishpacha, the nachem, af echad lo natan leikanes. In the day of the Shiva, all the rabbis came, was hundreds of people, and very emotional day, and he was standing there all day long, all the night, when people came from echad lo. And nobody let him in. He said, please, I'm asking, I'm not going to go away, Please just give me 2 seconds to talk to the father, to ask for forgiveness. Somebody came to the father and said, listen, let him go. He cannot live like that. Just let him release the pain. He's innocent. I mean, he didn't do it on purpose. You know what the father says? He He said to his son, tell him that I forgive him, but I don't want to see him anymore. I forgive him, but I don't want to see him. Let him go. He went outside and he saw it. The guy was crying. More than that, so hysterically, he ran away. Like, I don't know what happened. This guy didn't see him since then. And then on the same year, I saw something, Rabbeinu Yonah, something fascinating. He said, Hashem Yitbarach, every single year, he's coming here to this world, especially for Rosh Hashanah to Yom Kippur. Dirshu Hashem v'yimatzo kiru v'yoto karov, elu aseret yomei tshuva ben Rosh Hashanah l'Kippur. Hashem, come down to this world like if you pray by yourself, in your house, it's like you pray in Minyan. So powerful. Even you pray, cry to Hashem, it's like you pray in Minyan. Hashem is so close to us. But Rabbeinu Yonah said that you need to cry in those days and pray to Hashem, not just to forgive you, also to love you and show His face to you like nothing happened. You have to pray about it. Hashem, לא רק תסלח לי, גם תרצה אותי כאילו לא קרה כלום. Why? Rabbeinu Yonah said like that. Ki yitachen ha'avon nislach ve'en chefetz Hashem bo ve'lo yizkeh lesiyat ha'nishmaya ba'otah shana. Rabbeinu Yonah said, sometimes Hashem can forgive you, give you another year, but you're not going to see me. You're not going to see my help, my support. You know when you get kiss from God? When you find the right job, you find the right shidduch, when you find the right place to live, find the right community, when you got like so much kisses, and wow, Hashem, thank you. Wow, Hashem, you're here. Hashem, you love me so much, so perfectly. Everything going in the right way. I'm starting to live after so many years that I'm in pain. But Hashem said, I'm willing to forgive you, but I'm not promising that I'm going to see you and give you Ya'er Hashem Panav Elecha V'choneka. To see Hashem, you can live another life, another year with your wife, with your children. But every day, rollercoaster. What kind of life? This is Zuchrenu Lechaim, Kutvenu Besefer Chaim. What kind of life do you want? Eze shana anachnu rotzim? Shel ups and downs? And all of us know what is ups and downs. When you're going through in business, you're going through in relationship, when your wife coming with the RPG, and you want to go away, you want to kill her, you want to bury her, you want to run away, you want to do something. Your kids' problem, your health problem, financial problem. What kind of year? So we have the opportunity to do it, to make Hashem to forgive us and to love us and to give us much more than last year. How can we do it? איך אפשר לזכור לסייעתא דשמיא? לאהבה של השם, כאילו לא קרה כלום, like nothing happened. You know why? How? By acting like Hashem. You want to see Hashem? I want to see you activating your neshama, godly part in your neshama, in your soul. I want you to overcome your ego. I want you to forgive others like nothing happened and see them and smile to them like nothing happened and love them. What kind of way? Come on. No way. To love my ex-husband? To love my partner? To love my boss? After he hurt me and sold me and put me down and steal from me? Slicha shilech. Right?
Yeah.
How can we do it? How can you do it? How can you do it? How can we do it in a practical way? So tonight, I'm going to share with you how can we do it. Well, before that, I forgot to add, there is another level, the fourth level of forgiveness. Not only to do slicha, to do mechila, to forgive, to release all the emotion. Kapara is to be able to act like nothing happened, right? Even to willing to give him back another loan, another money to do him another favor. The fourth level is Meshiv Tova Tachat Ra'a. This guy hurt you, kick you out from your job, you find him another person. You help him to find a house, you help him to find a shidduch. He destroyed you, but you help him. The Zohar HaKadosh brings the story about Rav Acha. Rav Acha, he is the one who writes the Zohar HaKadosh, Rav Shimon Bar Yochai. Beishiva Vayidra Rava. And he said, one time he was walking, and he saw a person on the tree next to the cliff. And he saw a person lay down on the branch. Ra'a mishu yoshen ala etz ala me'al tzuk. And he realized there is a big snake coming down. And he walked there to warn this guy before he's going to eat him alive. While he walking, he saw the snake come and jump to bite this person. This person suddenly woke up or he moved any movement, and the snake was slipping down and he fell on the cliff. And he said he got saved. Nothing happened to him. When he woke up, also he was about to fail. The Zohar said, in the last moment he'd be able to hold down on the branch. And he got saved two times. Nitzal b'chayim shelo pa'amayim. Rav Acha came to him and he said, how did you do that? What exactly you do? You're so tzaddik. It's impossible. How Hashem saved your life two times? Tell me, what is ma'aseh bali adcha? What kind of action you do? There's no way that Hashem saved your life twice. He said, I'm not tzaddik, I'm a simple person. But I have one thing that I'm makpid. That if somebody hurt me, if somebody steal from me, if somebody insulted me, if somebody did something against me, not only that I forgive him, I'm find something to do, favor back to him. Meshiv tova tachat ra'a. Because of that, I have a lot of siyata nishma. Whatever I do, I see Hashem in my life. He said, wow, it's exactly like Yosef HaTzadik. Yosef HaTzadik, when the brother put him in the pit, and because of that, he was away from his house for 22 years. I have a chok me'abayt 22 shana. You can imagine a child, 17 years old, far away in different country. Imagine yourself in Iran. In Qatar. Or in Dubai. Dubai is a good place. But somewhere, I don't know, by yourself, alone, nobody, no family, no nothing. And then find yourself 10 years in the jail, another 2 years in the jail, fighting problems. Because of what? Because of the two brothers? Put you in the pit? Massive. After so many years, they came to Egypt. He could have killed them on the spot. Come on. Now it's my revenge time. He did what he did, he claimed that they're spies, whatever. In the end, he said like that. Achim Ba'olav, the brother came to him and he said, Avicha tziva levo, don't do anything to us, please. Our father said that don't make any revenge. Avar lahem Yosef, Yosef replied, you think that I'm going to do revenge? You thought to do something to hurt me. Lera'a, tem chashavtem lera'a. Elokim chashava letova. Hashem have a different plan. And Hashem make it for good for me. So there's nothing to do about you. That's why I'm not even have any grudge, anything towards you. So the first key for forgiveness, how can I forgive to someone? When someone did something for me, it's not about him. We all say in Rosh Hashanah, why Rosh Hashanah is before Yom Kippur? Because in order to forgive, first of all, you have to make sure that Hashem, He is the only one who controls the world. If you don't believe in Hashem, if you get upset on someone, David or Moshe or Yitzhak or Israel, you don't believe in me. You forget that I'm running the world. No Nobody can hurt a penny that belongs to you. Nobody can take your house, your business, your health to hurt you, to put you down. Nothing. If it's not written by me. If it's not good for you. So if you're getting upset, that's what the Gemara said, kol ha-kohes, ki'ilu oved avodah zarah. If you get upset, it's like you worship idol. I worship idol? Yes! Because you forgot that I'm behind you. I'm the security guard. I see on the computer the Satan bring me the PDF and show me what you did. And what is the punishment the Satan tell me? To put you 6 months in the hospital. Chas v'shalom. With the dializa. To move it. Like that. To be with sickness and problems and chemo. Chas v'shalom, God forbid it. What's supposed to happen? And I trained it to have so much mercy on you that I took this punishment and I sent you this guy to hurt you, to take $10,000 for you. And you get upset on him? If you would have believed in me, you would have stopped to dance. What? You suffer because of this guy? This guy kicked me out from my job. I was 5 months without any money. I was suffering. I'm going through hell because of this wife. I lost that. I lost that. I saw the computer. He's supposed to die 5 years ago. He's supposed to go through hell. Supposed to be in a jail. Supposed to go through something. And I got the payment for you, for this sufferer, for this guy, for this problem, to go from this house to this house to this job to this job to this pain. You're going through something you don't know. What's our tikkun? We don't know. We don't see the big picture. So in order to forgive someone, first of all, you have to train. Who am I? I'm the son of God, and God loved me so much that he's taking care of me. That if something happened, something else worse than that's supposed to happen. But why? I didn't do anything. You don't know. We don't know the cheshbonot, the calculation. We hurt someone a few years ago. We steal from someone. We lie to someone. We talk against someone. We don't know what's the payment. We ask Hashem, why me? Why? Why need to go through it? Why you cannot give me a normal job? Why? We're asking Hashem, why are we going through so much pain, so much suffering, health problem? People look for shidduch, for zivuk for so many years. Look for normal job, for certainty, for stability. People don't see their children. Somebody called me today. And he said that his wife kicked him out from the house. And he asked me, why me? He found himself doing kiddush by himself. On Friday, and another Friday, and another Friday. He said, why? Why did I do wrong? I pray every day, I put tefillin, I keep Shabbat, I keep kosher, I keep tzedakot. Why me? Why I'm suffering? It's not fair. It's not fair. So he's upset on Hashem, he's upset. It's not fair. So I told him, I'm so sorry for you. Let's try to put yourself in the shoes of God and see the event from the perspective of God and see it with the eyes of Emunah. Because without Emunah, we cannot go through anything in our life. If you don't believe that Hashem is behind it, you're going to hate the entire world. You're going to hate Hashem. You don't understand anything. We're going to do it in the end, Bezal Hashem, in meditation, how to see it in a different perspective. But the only thing that we have control in life, we don't have control what's going to happen. Nobody promised us anything. We have no guarantee for anything. That's why we blow the shofar. Do you remember the cry of Ima Shel Sisra? That she said that nothing is guaranteed life. But we do have control of two things. If you want it, write it down. Two things that the most control your life. Two things that control most of us. Anything that we go through in life. What is the most things that control our life? Money?
Amen.
You can have a lot of money and still be miserable. Yes or no?
Yes.
Love can have people that say that they love you, but you still be miserable. Yes or no?
Yes.
There's a two things that can control your life. It's meaning and emotion. Meaning, everything that you give meaning to the event, that can change your decision. Because X happened, the event happened. And then what's the meaning you give it to it? If you give it a good meaning, it's good for me, it's tikkun that I'm going through with my wife, it's my tikkun from past life, I don't know what I need to go through, but this is my tikkun, my midot, tikkun my ego, tikkun that I need to go through, the pain, my averot, my other girls, my other relationship that I went through, I need to pay now. What do you think? You're going to get now a wife and la la la? You're going to pay, Habibi. So you give it a good meaning. What is the feeling you're going to feel? You're going to feel good. Whatever happened, it's good for me. I feel good about it. And then I make a different decision. But if something happened and I have a bad meaning to it, bad meaning, this is bad. This guy is bad. This relationship is bad. Or whatever happened to me is bad. What kind of feeling I'm going to have? Bad feeling. What kind of a decision, what kind of an action I'm going to get? Very bad, based on that. So Yosef HaTzadik said, Atem chashavtem lera'a, you think for bad, but I'm changed the meaning. I cannot change the event. In order to be Yosef HaTzadik, I need to go through it. I don't know why. Why me? I was the biggest tzaddik. Why I need to go through it? To fix and to get Am Israel be in Egypt and not to make sin. Yosef היה צריך לעבור את כל התחנות, לשמור על התרועה והזוהה מה שהייתה במצרים. He needs to go through it. You know why? No. But he knows one thing. Elohim חשבה לטובה. Hashem make it for good. And once you change the meaning, this guy hurt me, this guy steal from me. The Gemara said, if you didn't give enough tzedakot, somebody else, make sure that you're going to give this money away. Yeah. You don't want to give tzedakah? No problem, don't give. Hold your hand. But I'm going to make sure that somebody else will take the money away from you. So when someone asks you for tzedakah, give right away. Because maybe Hashem wants to open the gate for you right now to see how much mercy you have. You give without thinking. You give without feeling. I also will give you, I'm not going to check anything. But if you still think, should I give, should I not, I don't have. Oh, okay, so I'm also going to check on you. So the first things in order to forgive someone, what we need to do? Change the meaning. He didn't do it on purpose. Or even if you do it on purpose, it's not about him. It's about I'm supposed to go through it or something worse than that. But Hashem paid it. Hashem shilem li la'avor derech ha'tzar, ha'tzar hazeh shi'im ishti. Hashem sit on the, in the heaven and he choose how much volume your wife is going to talk to you. A little bit. What's going to make him the best tikkun? This volume? Okay. What do you want? Leave me alone! The Gemara said about Rav, one of the Amoraim, that he used to take, to ask his wife, can you make me something sweet to eat? She make him something sour. When he asked her, can you make me something sour, something spicy? She make him something sweet. His son realized that whatever he asked her, She's doing against, opposite. So he heard, he said sour, he said sweet. And then she became sour. And then his father realized that he's lying, he said, don't lie. He said, so why are you still with this wife? Why are you not getting divorced? He said, Lo dayat shemigadlot et banenu, umatzilot otanu minachet dayenu. This is my zivug, this is my tikkun, I need to go through it. I have nothing to, as long as I get that you raise my kids for the Torah and prevent me to sin, that's it. So when you change the meaning and you have emunah that Hashem is control, either you play the game with God or you want to play the game with outside. If you want to play the game, the God's together, yeah, people pray with me over here. After Shachaborna, I'm going to kill this guy. I don't want to say the word that they use. Yes, I know. This guy, I have guys, Rabbi, I have connections. Tell you all the connections. Oh, what happened? Why you put two tefillin 2 minutes ago? Rabbeinu Tam, Rabbeinu Rashi, Rabbeinu Zen, Sarek Ota Dati, Hala. You don't believe in God. What are you talking about? You kufir. If you upset on someone, you kufir. So how can I do it? That's why if you say, you see the word mechila, mechila, it can be also mechila, a tunnel. In order to forgive someone, you have to go very deep. But also it's melashon, in Hebrew, machol, to dance. Because if you change the meaning, you start to dance. Why? You see the computer is supposed to be chas v'shalom in hospital, or something pain supposed to happen, and I just pay for this guy or whatever, yeah, I can handle it, it's okay. Somebody called me 2 weeks ago. There is a storm in Naples over there. And he said, Rabbi, I invest in 2 houses, we do a renovation, I spent so much money, I supposed to sell it this week. I didn't even took insurance. 4 trees, the biggest trees of my neighbors, fell on the 2 houses, break them down, smash them. Allah hakesef dod. Allah, he called me. He said, Rabbi, what can I do? Why Hashem did it to me? I said, you have to start dance. Hashem loved you so much. He said, how are you talking, Rabbi? What are you talking about? What I'm talking about, Hashem opened the computer. The tree is supposed to fall on your head and kill you on the spot. Or you're supposed to be in very injury in the hospital, Chas v'Shalom. Something's supposed to happen. He pays you by losing that, and you'll be able to fix it. So start to dance.
זה כפרה, מחילה, סליחה, זה הכל זה.
שתבח שמו. So change the meaning. This is the first key. Change the meaning. Second, in order, why it's so hard for us to forgive others? It's not because of someone hurt me. Listen to that. No one can hurt you unless you give him permission to do it. Listen to that. No one. If someone think about himself, wow, I'm so fat, so I don't look nice, or I have low self-esteem, I don't know how to make money, I don't know how to do that, da, 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 da. I think bad, negative thought about myself, and somebody came to me, oh, you're so fat. He gained weight, Chavivi, Rabbi, אתה אוכל טוב, משתבר שמו. מה קרה, אתה מקנה? Right? If you feel bad about yourself, if somebody pinch you and say something about you, he hurt you in an open wound. Right? יש פה פצע פצוע שאתה לא מרגיש טוב על עצמך, חושב לא טוב, מישהו פגע בך, that's why you got hurt. So in order to forgive to someone, you have to forgive yourself. Because no one can hurt you unless you give him permission to do it. So the reason that we not forgive others, because we not forgive to ourselves. We're going to do the meditation in the end. You're going to understand in 10 minutes. How much pain and how much anger and how much we hate part of ourselves. We hate part of ourselves. Why we not wake up on time? Why we not make enough money? Why I'm not good enough to my husband, to my wife? Why I'm not good enough? Why I'm not a good husband? Why I'm not a good father to my kids? Why I'm doing that? Why I know that it hurts me and destroy my, and I even undo it. Why I'm not, why, right? We hate so many things that we do and we're still doing it. So before you're hurt and then someone come, so we have an open wound. That's why you can be able to hurt me. But if I think that I'm the best, I'm a businessman, I make millions of dollars, I know that I'm very successful, or I have a good relationship, or I feel good about my body, my skin, or whatever, somebody will tell you, oh, you're such a poor guy, or oh, you're such an ugly, or you're such a 2x4. Lech habayta, I mean, who is this guy? You're not even gonna get, he's not gonna get into you, right? So instead of blame someone, first of all, you can take the hurt or the words as a criticize. Instead of taking the criticize a negative way, maybe it's a calling. You need to lose weight a little bit. Maybe it's a calling, you need to take care of yourself, right? Maybe it is a calling, someone did something or say something that very bothered me. The Baal Shem Tov said, whatever you see in someone, or someone tells you that it's bothering you, which means that you have it inside of you. But I cannot forgive my wife, I cannot forgive my husband, he says something. Yeah, it hurts you so much because it's so true that you don't want to face it. You don't want to face that you also lie sometimes. No. You also cheat a little bit. You're also doing a lot of things that you don't know. You want to check it out? I love the sessions with couples about trust. Why? I never cheat. I'm so loyal. I'm so honest. Oh, you're so honest. Why? Come to me. 2 sessions, I'm going to break you down. Without hypnosis. With hypnosis in the first session. So how this person can lie to me? How this person did to me? How? You're not cheating? You're not stealing money from people? You're so loyal? You're not stealing from the IRS? You're not taking to Orlando your 5 little children and the little one, 4 years old? No, he's 2. He's 2. הילד אוכל עוד שנייה את השומר גם כן. No, he's two years old. Ah, to save 100 bucks. So you're not lying? כל השבעה שלו כתבים זה. So, instead of blame to someone, take it and learn from it. So too. Not to forgive someone, it's basically put yourself in a jail and carry it and let other people to control your emotion and happiness. By not forgive someone, you let other people to make you a victim. Instead of being the one who have control in your happiness, in your life, this guy did to me, this guy did to me, yalla shachel. It's not even worth 5 minutes of your time to spend to talk and to say it and to get. Yala, forgive. Move on. Oh, he steal from you? He did something? Okay, learn from your mistake. You close your eyes, you let him use your money, you let him manage the business in this way, or you let him. No, so be sophisticated, be more organized. You have something in a relationship, it's a calling. You want to behave in something? Whatever we behave or we get upset, it's because we don't get our needs. There's a needs calling. So if your wife calling you or hurt you using the words that she don't want to use, or your husband insulting you or put you down, it's because he's screaming, he don't have the right words to express how much he needs you to pay attention, to honor, to respect him, to give him his needs. So he's become nasty, trying to be controlled. Shut up. Right? But how are you talking like that? You become an animal. If you're not going to feed his needs, he's going to become an animal.
Yes or no? So you play games. So instead of be upset, ask yourself, it's an actionable, you can do something about it. Do something about it. If it's not actionable, learn from it and make it part of your success. Something happened in a relationship that didn't work out, or you got divorced, you got separated, or you move on. Learn it from the next time, next relationship. I said to people, don't go to the next relationship without learning about relationship. Zad Hashem, after the Chagim, we're going to launch the course about relationship and coaching. Zad Hashem, in this room. And Zad Hashem, I'm going to send after the Chagim all the information, whoever wants to sign up. It'll be something phenomenal with a workshop and a lot of deep. Yeah, Baruch Hashem. Hashem wants it to happen now. So, you see. So, Bezat Hashem. So, if it's actionable, do something about it. It's nothing to be upset or to hurt or to get. Because you're not releasing yourself. So, by forgiving, it's by being able to free yourself. To free yourself, to let it go. To overcome. It's not worth it. Let it go. But yeah, no. I'm not a victim anymore. You know how people hurt me? You know how many people stolen me? You know how many people tried to put me down? But I don't let it happen. We move on. Become stronger. Somebody will ask me, 5 years ago, 3 years ago, you want to open your own shul with a smooth way, 1, 2, 3, boom, open a new shul, or you want to go through all what you have gone through? It's no way. I learned so much. And become stronger and stronger and get to know Hashem much more and to see that whatever I got through Hashem is taking care of others. It's nothing to do with upset. It's nothing to do with others. I love everyone and I love even I give him back a favor. Yes or no? They know what I'm talking about. Not only that I forgive, I love and I help them even more. Like nothing happened. This is the most pleasure in the world. Because you understand that Hashem waits for you to open this. Okay, so this guy needs like that, that, that. Who cares? Let it go. Move on. By moving on. Oh Hashem. See? They're a witness. There are three of them witnessed what I've gone through 3-4 years ago. And I thought this is the end. Every end, it is just the beginning of something new. So if something hurt you or kick you or you move on, you just learn for you. It's part of your success. So you got something, learn about it, invest in yourself. Instead of blame and running away from the truth, running away from the reality, running away from going out from your comfort zone. No, you have to go out of your comfort zone and do something about it with your relationship. By getting in the point that I don't forgive, you don't let yourself to the possibility to improve your relationship, to fix your relationship. Maybe this much more deeper level that you need to go. And only because of this crisis, and only because of this fight, you'll be able to do it. But you have to let it go to release. So, that's why Hashem said, you want me to forgive you and love you and give you more and more and more? Be like me. Kol ha'ma'avir al midotav mochalim lo al kol psha'av. Whoever is overcome is midot and is willing to forgive. Hashem is mochel. Hashem is soleach. Hashem is forgive and nothing happened. Hashem is give you everything. Don't hold anything to anyone. Just continue to love. And release and understand that everything from Hashem. That's what I said to you, the story about the Chaim Kanevsky, that someone came to him and he said, Rabbi, I don't have children for 17 years. What should I do? What should I do? He said, buy the first Aliyah in Rosh Hashanah. It's gula for children. The maftir, slicha. He purchased $2,000, $3,000, and when he get to the Aliyah, the Gabbai said, listen, these two brothers before you that they cannot get after another, you need to switch. You cannot get the Aliyah. He said, what? I spent so much money. I went for this moment. Now I want me to give up to this guy? He said, you know what? The rabbi said, that it is what it is, the halakha,
להלכה הלכה, give me my money back, מה זה? להלכה.
זה לא
אמור. He said, you know what, I'm gonna forgive this guy, I'm gonna get a different aliyah, even I was waiting for this moment for 17 years. He came to a plaque and asked me back. And he said, Rabbi, I listened to you, I purchased the aliyah, and I was waiting for this moment. And look what happened. Hakanevsky said, you tried the entire sgulot in the world, but you didn't try the sgula of overcome your midot and forgive to someone. This is the most powerful sgula in the world, and because of that, you're going to have a child this year. After 9 months, he called Hakanevsky and invited to be Sandak. I said, it's all right. Because this is the most powerful thing to be able to do. You see Hashem in any aspect. You think that you know Hashem? Believe me, you don't know enough. So enough is enough to carry all the pain, the suffering, the words, the emotions the, from other people that happened 2, 3, 5 years ago. Enough! Let it go! Let it go! Do something about it! Let it go. Open a new possibility, new page with the relationship, new page with your wife. Because your wife is not going to do anything if you still hold it. Your husband is not willing to do anything and improve the relationship or work even the relationship if you still don't forgive him or blame him for something that happened for many years ago. There's a lot of people, couples that have trauma for years. He did something 10 years ago, 20 years ago. Come on. So you want to bury both of you and go like that and pretend like you're happy and you're dead inside, let it go. So that's what we have Yom Kippur. And we have the opportunity to release ourselves to be free. I'm going to do meditation in 2 minutes. And going deep inside, not just to forgiveness of others, okay? Because in order to forgive others, we need to forgive ourselves. How can we do it? There's few ways how to do it. We can do it in your conscious mind by closing your eyes and go through meditation, guided meditation. Or we can do, I do it sometimes with hypnosis, where I put you in deep level sleep and talk to your subconscious mind and do the inner child technique to go through your trauma, all the stuff that you have gone through, and talk to yourself in the past. It's a very amazing experience. Whoever wants to do it, you can go to my website and book a session. But, but, it's not funny. So, but we can do it now. We can do it now together. And Be'ezrat Hashem will be able to let it go, all those people, all the resentment, all the pain, all the suffering, all the anger that we carry, release it, open the new year. And believe me, you see miracles, Yeshuot, you see the salvation, you see parnasah, you see happiness, you see nachat, you see shlovayit, you're going to see an amazing relationship, everything will be changed. Because when you release and forgive, mechila, it's also the word machala. Machala, which means sickness. If you hold it, people getting sick. Chas v'shalom for cancer and any kind of bad sickness because they carry so many years with resentment. They don't want to release. No, I'm not gonna forgive this guy. I'm not gonna do. Ma, you want to be just? You want to justify to be the right one? You are the one who suffer. This guy hurt you a year ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago. He's already married to another person, you're already successful with another, making money, and you're the one who suffer. Move on. Instead of waste time to tell everyone and to waste time by digging what happened, move on and build something and show him. Look what I built. That's going to be the most pleasure that can you feel that you didn't let other people to win. You didn't let other people to control your happiness. Those two things you can control in your life, as I said, meaning and emotion, in order to continue and to live normal life and happiness, you have to be master in your emotion. If You don't know how to control it. So every person that says something, no, I'm going to a different community. No, I'm going to leave this guy. I'm going to leave. מה, אתה ילד קטן? אז מישהו אמר לך משהו, יאללה, שחררי, יאללה, את בת שלוש. You see people 50, 60 years old, because of one word, they've gone crazy. So let it go. Let enter this Yom Kippur. ביום הזה יחפר עליכם. Come with love, happiness. To start Yom Kippur with this beautiful song, לך אליתי שוקתי. The song of it. Ibn Ezra, he wrote this song and he said, we say this song, if somebody chas v'shalom, going to leave the world without having the ability to say vidui, this is going to be the last vidui. That basically we said, Hashem, my heart, my hands, my legs, my body, everything to you, everything, I don't want to believe in anybody, I don't want to get involved in anything, just to be with you, to live with you, to live a spiritual life, that's going to be כותבנו לחיים בספר חיים. That's going to be the book of life. To live with Hashem. To have emunah in your house. To have faith in your relationship. And whatever you're going through. So if you want to sue someone, you want to be justice, Hashem also will be justice for you. And look what's wrong. But if you let it go, you don't makbid, you release, you don't look for justice. You don't want to sue this guy. No, I don't want to sue him. And let it go. And learn from it. Hashem also. Ma'avir Rishon Rishon. Hashem will get away this guy. Give him. 200,000, 300,000, $1 million. Give him Shidduch. Give him Sim. Because you overcome your midot. So let's do it together in 5 minutes. Okay? You all ready? Let me just a second. Okay, we're gonna close this mic. Yeah, don't go yet. Don't go. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Stay. Sorry, nobody go. No, the other light. Yeah. No, leave the chandelier. One of the chandelier, yeah. Okay, please, no talking. Make it dim a little bit. And make the music loud. You're great. Okay? Okay. So now, I want all of you, first of all, close your eyes. Close your eyes and take a deep breath. Take a deep breath, let it out. I want you to take a moment to think about your lifetime, to think about all the past few years, whatever in your relationship, whatever in your career, your business, where you can take a long trip from your childhood until today, the time that you grow up, your childhood, your teenager, the time that you got married, the time that you got the first child, where you grow up and you see and meet more people moving from place to place, going through a lot of events and many, many people. And I want you, take a moment, think about someone that hurts you the most. I want you to take and think about it. See it. See the event like it's happening right now. I want you to step into the event. One event, one person that hurts you the most. Whether in your relationship, whether it's your wife, your girlfriend, your husband, your boyfriend, whether it's a problem with your son, your sibling, your uncle, whether it's just your friend, best friend, that betrayed, best friend that lied to you, put you down, steal money from you, steal the business from you, or someone from the street, or someone that hurt you or insulting you. I want you to take this event and step into this event right now. I want you to take a moment and imagine that you have a chair in front of you. Whether someone that you see it vividly, I want you to see the face. I want you to feel the pain. I want you to hear the word that he said to you. I want you to hear the word, the line that he promised you, or the words that he used in the fight moment. I want you to look at it. Take another deep breath and sit down. Sit down on the chair and see him in front of you. I want you to look at him as a person. Look into his eyes. I want you to step in through this moment and feel the pain, the insulted, feel the money, the suffering, the pain that you have gone through, that he's not even aware, he not even know how much damage he did for you. I want you to get all this emotion at once and have this anger and feel in your mind the word, you hurt me. You hurt me the most when you say this word. You hurt me the most when you didn't appreciate me. When you put me down, you didn't support me. You was not here for you. You were not there for me. You betrayed. You lied to me. I want you to feel this pain, this emotion, this anger, this pain. And see it like it's happening right now. Like you cannot even forgive this guy, this girl, this person. Now I want you to take a step moment and lift yourself above your body, above, and sit down in this chair instead of this person. I want you to take a deep breath, continue to close your eyes. I want you to be like this person and talk instead of him. What is the words that he could have said to you that can make you calm down, make you release and forget him? I want you to step in this moment to see, maybe he went through hard life, maybe he didn't have money, maybe he got through a lot of things in his relationship, maybe he got trauma in his childhood, he didn't get the support and love from his parents, maybe it was a moment that he was not even aware. It's a moment that he explodes so much anger for something that is not even relevant to you. I want you to step into this moment. Send him so much mercy. Have a mercy on this guy, on this girl, this event. And understand that whatever happened, it happened for a good reason. And I want you to step in this moment and talk instead of you. I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't mean to put you down. I didn't mean to make so much damage for you. I didn't know I was in survival mode. I just act because I was scared, because I was going through something. I thought I'm gonna lose everything. I didn't even see you. For a moment, I want you to step into this moment, talk to yourself. I would have even imagined what you're going through. If I wouldn't know it, I wouldn't take the money, I wouldn't cheat, I wouldn't say these words, I wouldn't act like that. Do you forgive me? Do you forgive me? Please, I'm asking for your forgiveness. Please forgive. Please forgive me because I'm so lonely today. Please forgive me because I have so much fear that I cannot even express and say it to you. I was using my ego, my anger, my words, my nasty mouth, but I was so much fear. and I didn't know how to say it that I love you. I didn't know how to say it, that I do want to fix my relationship. I do want to come back. I do want to be with you. I do want to open a business. I do want, but I just cannot do it. I didn't know how to handle it. That's why I was running away. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. I'll let it go. Now I want you to take a deep breath and be yourself again. And look at this person again. And he said, I release you and I forgive you like nothing happened. I forgive you because I understand you. I understand where you come from. I understand what you went through. I don't want to judge you. I want to release you from here, for now. And I forgive you for 100%. I don't want to feel any grudge, any judgment, any jealousy, anything. I want you to look into this person's eye, whether it's your friends, your husband, your wife, your father. I want you to look at your father's eyes and say, Father, I'm forgive you. I want you to look at your mother's eyes. Mom, I forgive you. You didn't try to hurt me. I know that you really love me. You really support me when you have so much on your hand. You have so much other siblings to take care of. You work in three jobs. That's why you cannot show me your love, your attention. You didn't do it on purpose. I forgive you and I love you. I want to let it go. Now I want you to take another deep breath. And exhale. And I want you to look in this moment, this event, or this person, or whatever happened to you, and look in the eyes of Hashem, God's eyes. I want you to look at this event, at this person, and I want you to step into God's eyes. Listen to the voice of God. I'm here and I love you. Whatever you're going through is not about him. Something else is supposed to happen. And I sent this guy to release their tikkun, to make you a little bit suffering, to make you a little bit pain, to take a little bit money from you. But I love you and I'm here for you. I don't want to hurt you. I want you to step into God's eye and see God's perspective and release. It's not about this guy. It's not about those people. It's not about this relationship. It's not about anyone. And say, I forgive you like God. The last step that I want you to go through, not to go into yourself, because in order to forgive someone, you have to forgive yourself. I want you to go into yourself, to the parts that you don't like, to the parts of yourself that hurts you, the part of yourself that put you down, part of yourself who have a doubt on you, part of yourself who make you angry, make you upset, make you sad, make you feel lonely, make you feel unsupportive, the part of yourself that make you eat, overeat, part of yourself that make you not successful, the part of yourself that has so much fear. And I want you to release and forgive him by stepping into this part of yourself and talking to yourself from this part. Don't hate me. Don't have any grudge and any pain and any suffering and any feeling, bad feeling towards me, because I'm here to protect you. The reason that I let you to eat, overeat, is to protect you. Because I feel that you're sad. I feel without this cigarette, without this food, without these things that you have done, you will not even survive. So I let you to sleep. I let you to do something else. But I'm here to protect you. To protect you. I'm here to make you calm. I'm here to make sure that you're okay. Not to hurt you. Now I want you to step into yourself and look at this part and say, I forgive you. I forgive you and thank you I don't need you to be protected. I'm okay. I just want to be okay. Just remind me sometimes that I am okay, that I am loved, but I forgive you and I release all the pain, all the anger. I'm not no longer self-sabotage and hitting myself and beating myself up. That's who I am. And I'm doing my best as I can. Now take all of you and understand that you are being neshama. There's no me, there's no you, there's no David, there's no Moshe, there's no other girl, there's nobody. Everybody in the same picture, in the same neshama, same soul. We all have the godly power to forgive, to release, by understanding that everything is for good and everything happened for a reason, for us to continue to grow, to see the future that we don't see it, to see the best relationship, to open a new page. So this is a time to release, to forgive. Maybe I didn't give enough to my husband, that's why he was like that. He was waiting and looking for something outside. Maybe I didn't go and give to my wife enough. That's why she was upset and treat me like that. Maybe I didn't care about my business, my community, my friends enough. That's how they behave like that. But nobody have a bad intention. Even they have a release and a let it go. Now I want you to step out and see yourself and see the light come from God all over your body, all over your neshama, and purify yourself full of love and send this energy of love to your husband, to your wife, to your ex-wife, to your children, to your parents, to all the people that you have gone through in your life, and let it go and start to fly and feel the godly power within you and step in to a new beginning, a new year. You will see God, you will see new possibilities from now on in the new year. Welcome back. You can open your eyes. Wow. Can I open the light? How was it for you?
Very good.
Very good. You can imagine. Open all the lights, the other one, the light one. Wow. Do you see how much we can achieve and how much we can get by just releasing and loving ourselves, loving others like nothing happened? I want to wish all of you שנה טובה ומבורכת. שנה של אושר, בריאות, peace and happiness. No stress, no fighting. No any drama anymore. This year Hashem will open all the gates in the heaven to bring you shefa, abundance, parnasah, life and happiness and shalom bayit. Bring the Shekhinah into your house. You're going to have an amazing year בעזרת Hashem. Amen ve-amen. Thank you again all for coming. One quick notice before you go. I want Bezrat Hashem. Just for the story. First of all, don't forget Bezrat Hashem to share the classes, and whoever is not in the WhatsApp group can add you to the WhatsApp group, bring more friends, Bezrat Hashem. Bezrat Hashem, as I said, we have the coaching classes, the coaching course after the Chagim, and the relationship, whoever wants to sign up, we can talk to you after. Also, you have the lighting candles, magnet, put it on your fridge. You have over there the website, you can follow all the you can get all the notification and updates over there. And also, whoever wants to do kaparot for Yom Kippur, $18 per person, can do it right now if you want for a couple minutes. If not, you can do it later by sending me your names, and I will do it here. in your free time. Send me your names that you want. It's for your children. It's $18 per person. You can sell to my number or to the website over there. We can do it. Bezrat Hashem, and I wish you Shana Tova, Borechet, Machatina Tova, and see you Bezrat Hashem next week before Chag HaSukkot, Bezrat Hashem.
Amen. Shana Tova. Wow, you see, it was worth it to...